Over the past year, many Surface Duo 2 owners have experienced a short audio delay while playing certain games on their device. The problem shows up in RetroArch, Citra, Dolphin, Drastic, and even Xbox Cloud Gaming, as this 1 second disconnect between controller input and audio output. Needless to say, it can be kind of irritating. Though it's only recently that I've actually noticed it on my own device. That's likely owed to the fact that I mainly use my Duo 2 for productivity tasks these days, and when I do play games, I typically either turn off the sound or listen through Bluetooth earbuds to not disturb my wife. As such, it hasn't really been too much of an issue for me. However, I recently received a comment on my dual screen hardware roundup video asking about it, and I figured it might be useful to demonstrate what y'all can do if it happens on your own devices. Before I go further, let's review the actual issue. First, here's a 3DS playing Super Mario 3D Land. Now, here's a Surface Duo 2 playing 3D Land with the latest version of Citra. As you can hear, audio from each jump and action on the Duo 2 slightly lags each button press, far more than expected of just random emulation jank. The issue was first reported following an update last year for certain applications recognized as games by Android. The best guesses I've seen is that it's the result of an audio driver glitch that could potentially be patched by Microsoft in a future update. Unfortunately, we're fast approaching the end of support for the Duo 2, and there's no real sign Microsoft will do anything to fix the issue. But that doesn't mean all is lost, though. While not ideal, there are a couple workarounds folks can use if they plan to use their Duo 2 for gaming. The first centers around Bluetooth audio. Once more, here's a 3DS playing 3D Land. Next, here's the Duo 2 playing 3D Land like normal. Now, here's the same Duo 2 with the Bluetooth fixed. The difference with the final audio test is that I connected and disconnected a Bluetooth speaker before recording. Essentially, anytime you want to play a game through the Duo 2's speakers, you can connect and disconnect a Bluetooth device to avoid the audio issues altogether. Likewise, if you're fine with headphones or earbuds, using Bluetooth headphones for audio has worked equally as well for me. I've honestly no clue why this specific fix works, but it is a reliable solution. If you're someone who already carries Bluetooth earbuds around with them, it's also likely a convenient solution. It's only really for those who want to play with speaker audio in short bursts, where it's probably a bit of a hassle altogether. For those types of folks, they probably don't want to connect and disconnect Bluetooth every time they want to play a game. Luckily, for those folks, there's another solution that works just as well. Just, you know, change which apps you're using. The audio delay doesn't impact all apps recognized as games by Android. While testing various Android games like Death's Door, Zenless Zone Zero, and Super Mario Run, the audio sounded perfectly fine. Yet, while testing Dead Cells and Xbox Cloud Streaming, the delay was obvious. It's unclear why certain games are impacted while others aren't, and could very well come down to very specific games being coded just a bit differently. If you have a game you want to play on a Duo 2, but couldn't be bothered with Bluetooth connections, testing is the only way to know for sure. And if you run into a delay, it might be best to skip that game for now, and look for something else to play. Emulation apps are much the same. Citra, Drastic, and RetroArch all exhibit the same audio delay. However, Lemuroid and Melon DS both run perfectly fine. Again, it's unclear why these specific apps are different, beyond being just a bit newer to the scene. But they're at least great apps that'll scratch folks' dual-screen emulation itch without any additional fuss. In fact, even without the audio error, I'd generally recommend giving them a shot. Both apps are great for DS emulation, and Lemuroid feels sufficient for 3DS emulation with its Citra core, as long as you recognize that it's labeled as a beta feature, of course. Not to mention, they're both a lot more modern and streamlined than most other emulation offerings. Considering how many folks couldn't be bothered to mess around with RetroArch due to its clutter, Lemuroid, in particular, seems like a solid alternative. Though, let's be perfectly clear here. Swapping emulators isn't necessarily a perfect solution. While both apps cover a huge chunk of what folks are missing from the other big emulators, they definitely don't cover PS2, Dolphin, or Wii emulation. Considering how great the Duo 2's 4x3 displays are for all of those systems, it's a bit of a bummer. Melon DS and Lemuroid also fall behind quite a bit when it comes to customizability. It's great that they're more streamlined and easier to use up front. However, right now, you aren't going to find easy options to make fine adjustments to screen and touch controller locations. Screen arrangement in particular is kind of a letdown when using touch controls, which tends to be what I use for touchscreen heavy games like Mario vs. Donkey Kong or Midios. Everything just feels a bit more cramped than with either Drastic or newer versions of Citra. Even still, if you're using a Duo 2 specifically as an emulation machine, it might be worthwhile to go with the less problematic apps when you can. Of course, the ideal solution is that Microsoft makes this video unnecessary by pushing an update to fix the audio issue before support ends for the Pocket Tablet. Though, at this point, I don't think any Duo 2 owners are necessarily holding their breath for more than security updates. Still, as it was at launch, the Surface Duo 2 is still the best dual-screen Android handheld ever released, as long as you're willing to work around some of its quirks. Those are my thoughts, though, and I'd love to know how y'all are doing. Do you know of any other fixes or gaming apps that don't have the audio issue? Feel free to post them in the comments to let me know and help spread the word. As always, if this video was helpful at all, go ahead and give it a like, and then get subscribed for at least one more Surface Duo 2 video in the coming months. Like I did with the Duo 1, it seems only fitting to do a final recap on the device after security updates have ended. I'll also include some links down in the video description to previous videos on the Duo 1 and Duo 2, in case you're interested in those. That's gonna be all for this video though. Thank you so much for watching all the way until the end, and until next time, catch you later.